Friends, I will talk to you about maintenance and reliability. Is there any difference between the two terms? Are they the same thing for the same professionals? Or how do you do in your daily practice? In my view, the main objective of the maintenance is to keep all our equipments running. Running in an efficient way, running in a very proper way, and reliable manner. How do you ensure? To ensure everything that is running properly, you have to follow some basic principles of engineering. So I have to be engineer. There may be, you know, something you would call, no, we need technicians for the maintenance, we need many people like consultants, like the people from other areas, like a software, for example. They are people who are providing you maintenance software. But in all the things, I would say that until and unless there is an engineer, it is very difficult to understand how we do the maintenance. For the maintenance, whatever engineering, mathematics, or you can say science, physics, whatever it is needed, it is all about how to keep your equipment, your systems, your whatever built for performing the things in a quite proper way. So let us start very simple. Simple in the things for example, you are a engineer, young engineer, in any concern, any industry, take for a while. Why I want to say that? Because I am much, you can say, exposed to the industrial life. But it doesn't mean that without industry you cannot have a maintenance. For example, if your AC is not working in your home, you need maintenance. Or when the electricity is not coming in your home, you need some technicians from the electricity department to repair. In other words, our day-to-day life, we need the equipments to keep in running condition. That's all. How do you do it? There are, you can say, a lot of knowledge, informations, principles, practices, what you would say, that research. Because it's two-way things. Whatever we design based upon our experiences obtained from the performance of the equipment in the field and the feedbacks. For example, if you see anything 20 years before and now the same thing you see now, take any equipment, take, you can say, any gadget, any device, you will find some differences. I will not say basic differences, but at least differences in how to operate and maintain. Why? Because with the times we have improved designs, improved reliability, improved, you can say, utility, and also using of the less resources for keeping our equipment running. In other words, you have a less and less maintenance cost. So a lot of developments happened in the past 40 years. Taking the advantage of the development in engineering and development is in technology. You know, we engineers use the word technology. Technology in a sense, how to do the things by using your computers, your systems, and whatever new developments in every area, like for example, material, that you are going to use so that you come out with the objective of having a systems running efficiently with less resources, causing less pollution, causing, you can say, less wastes. So ultimate objective that we have to make equipments, gadgets, systems which are not only sustainable, which are not only doing less pollution, which are not only doing less energy consumptions, but they are smart also. How do you define the smart? Smart simply means whatever you do by consuming less power and they are more safe and reliable. In this, what happened, what you call this industry 4.0, we actually there are no different phases in industry, you might be knowing very well industrial revolution what you call, but today in we are in the phase of industry 4.0. simply means that in the era of using mobile phones and computers, most of the processes are going to be, you can say, based upon the using the these type of gadgets. For example, now you are purchasing mostly online, you are being delivered your whatever requirements, from even vegetables to your food items to clothes, or you can say even furniture and all that, you are going to be delivered by some online company. How was it possible? Because it was possible that we have made systems like that where you order and pay and everything is very, very safe, so that you are insured. For example, when your delivery boy comes to you, he has some gadgets, mobile phone and all that. Sometimes you have to pay cash, already paid. He simply doesn't ask any questions and he delivers the parcel. So how it became possible? Because of using the technology. So there is a difference slightly between technology and engineering. Technology is the, you can say, accumulation of all the components of the systems which makes our daily routine life easy. In other words, like consuming the electricity, consuming the facilities like transport or using the car and all those things, people are not concerned about what is happening inside the car, how does the engine work, what thermodynamics principles and mechanical engineering has gone into it in designing it. They are not interested. They are interested that how much comfort is that when you are driving, plus how much it is safe and reliable. Reliability means that whenever you need anything, it must be functioning. Reliability doesn't mean that you know that my machine or my car, or you can say my any gadget, my device, whether it is a laptop or all those things, is running without concern very beautifully. Reliability simply means that whenever you want to use, you are insured, you are confident. How much confident? Depends. That is the reliability. You may have a confidence of 50%, 60%, 80%, 90%. Reliability, actually, it is a term which comes from the probability of any event. I will give you another example. Suppose you flip a coin. So when you are flipping the coin, what are the results? Results will be either you will have a head or you will have a tail. But how much you are confident that in your next flip it will be tail? Can you tell in the terms of percentages? I will give another concept. How your mind think about the reliability? For example, you have gone to a doctor, and he says that operation is to be done for a particular organ. And you say, doctor, what is the procedure? Whether it is a complicated operation? How much problem may come? So you know, he will tell everything that you are convinced that the operation is reliable, the procedure is reliable, and it is a, you can say, almost no problem. But even then you would like to know, sir, is there any risk? Then he will tell you. Why? Because he has to get signed the papers where it is written, something happens, it is a responsibility yours and it is your concern. So if the operation is like that, where, based upon the, you can say, past experience, past events, the success chances has been either maybe 90% or 80% or 89% or 92%. So how do you calculate this 92%, 89%? It is not in the air. When we talk in our general terms in day-to-day life, we say a percentage. This is based upon our intuition. Intuition means most of the times you feel this is correct. When you say 50%, you have the idea that there is a 50-50% chance of any event. Or you can say 60-70% chance or 80% chance. This is your intuition. But when the things are calculated with the past events, with the past data, so there is a mathematics, what is known as a probability mathematics. Probability mathematics means that you have data based upon which you can be insured, you can feel confident that based upon the past events in a similar situations, this is the probability of any event, or you can say the chance of happening of any event. So we will come back to again to our example, what do you mean by reliability, or what do you mean by the reliability in a sense that you are confident. So again I will go to the example where you are saying the coin is flipped and you are not knowing what will happen. But the past event says there is a 50-50% chances. That is what you can say mathematical calculation and proven one. So in a similar way, wherever you have the data of any event, you have the chances, probability, or you can say the confidence level. That's why you are might be having the different type of, you can say, curves, normal curves, T curves. Most of the research we do in the science is based upon the statistical calculations. So probability mathematics, statistics, these are the based upon the data, and most of the research is done in that manner. So reliability is coming from that area. If you say that your equipment is going to run for 5 years and the chances of running it continuously without any failure of the equipment is 90%, means if you run these similar equipments, you have many similar equipments and you are running the same equipment in a similar conditions, although which is practically impossible. But even then it will give some figure that may be saying that in the 5 years, suppose if you have a 100 equipments, the chances are there only 10 will fail before 5 years and others may survive. When you are doing actual things, it may not come. Whether it failed 10 or 15 or 12 or even can say 18, But some part you have some idea, it will not be like that. You have to failure of in the range of, you can say, maybe more than 40 or 50, or you can say beyond 20, 25. So this calculation, this mathematical probability is giving your confidence based upon the past data that the reliability of this equipment in running similar circumstances is 90%. So should I repeat it again to make you understand what we mean by reliability? Or I think you might have understood. So the job of maintenance engineer, head of engineering, whatever you call it, because whether it is a top person and at the person at the technician level, the objective is to maintain the equipment. And when you say as a confident person that this equipment will run for 2 years at the reliability of 90%, then you can say the chances are only 10%. Means when you are comparing with another equipment which is only reliable 60%, and when you are comparing with 90%, you have a clear idea that you have a better maintenance in the case of the equipment which has 90% reliability in comparison to 60% reliability. But it doesn't mean that equipment will not fail. Fortunately and unfortunately, we are in such a stage that the prediction is never true 100%. Prediction is only in the chances, in the probability. So the number will decide where we have a more reliability or less reliability, or do we have any scope for the improvement of the reliability. So reliability is coming there. Now the things, whatever you do, whether philosophy, whether maintenance strategy or maintenance practices or your systems or you can say procedures, whatever methodology you adopt and you act in getting that reliability, simply is a maintenance in action. But in my view, maintenance and reliability, you cannot separate like a coin. They are the, you can say, two faces of the same thing. Same thing means, as a maintenance engineer and as a man responsible for running the machines continuously, whether you call you as a reliability engineer or inspection engineer or maintenance engineer or you can say the corrosion engineer, the objective is same, that you have to keep your equipment, your system, your gadget or device running and performing in a quite efficient and reliable as well as safe manner. Today I will end my expression about the ideas about the maintenance and all that. Just now we will continue to talk. I hope you will give the comments on this my first video, and I would like to correlate with you, I mean conversational with you. And I want to make more, you can say, participative, so that my objective of connecting with you and discussing as a professional of maintenance becomes, you can say, beneficial to all of us. Okay, thank you very much. Thanks all.